We took apart the brand new Anker 120W GaN Prime charger several days ago. You can click the upright corner and have a look. And today we got another product released at Anker event, the Anker 737 power bank. It can support 140W input and output. It's also the first power bank that supports the PD3.1 protocol. Next, let's check it in detail. What we got is the Chinese version, but it also continues the GaN Prime series design. Open the box, it contains the power bank itself, cable, a small bag, and manual. This is a dual USB-C cable, and the connector is printed with Anker and 140W, which means the cable supports up to 140W. The USB-C connector is not full pin design, and the length is about 61cm. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM002C shows it can support 50V, 5A, 240W EPR. It adopts PC ABS material, and the front can be divided into a display and the Anker logo. There is a button on the side, you can use it to control the display. The display is controlled by a gravity sensor, so you can get the charging information at a glance in all directions. Press the side button, you can enter the auto screen off settings. Press again to check the remaining capacity. The specs info are printed on the back, model is A1289. The battery capacity is 24,000 mAh and can be divided into 6 pieces of 4,000 mAh battery cells. And the rated capacity is 13,500 mAh. USB-C 1 can support 140W input and output. USB-C 2 only supports 140W output. And USB-A only supports 18W output. You can pause to take a look. It's equipped with two USB-C and a USB-A ports, all in Anker Blue. The size of this power bank is about 156 by 55 by 49.5mm. Compared with iPhone 13 Pro, it's slightly longer. And the weight is about 631 grams. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C 1 supports AFC, QC5, PD3.1, and PPS protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, 28V, 5A, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols and PDO information of USB-C 2 are the same as USB-C 1, so they have the same output performance. And then the USB-A supports FCP, AFC, QC 3.0, and Apple 2.4M protocols. Use this power bank to charge the MacBook Pro 2021. The charging power is about 140W, which has successfully activated the PD3.1. Next, let's use the spudger to remove the metal plate and check the internal components to see how it can support PD3.1. There are graphite thermal pads inside the top cover. The PCBA module is fixed with screws, and the display is connected to PCB via flat cable. Remove all the screws. The back of the module is covered with thermal pad to dissipate heat, and the second PCB is connected to the battery pack used for battery protection and capacity detection. Fix the power bank on the cutting machine, and then separate the internal module. From the side, we found it has two layers. The first layer has two 21700 battery cells and the PCBs. The lower deck has extra 4 battery cells. They are connected in series and each one is 4000 mAh. The body paper is pasted on the positive of the battery cell for insulation. Remove the PCB and the battery cells, which are fixed by double-sided tape. The battery cell is from Lishen. It supports 6A current, and the charging limit voltage is 4.2 volts. The protocol chip, resistors, and MOSFETs are on the front, nothing on the back. So let's introduce all components of this PCB. The battery protection chip is from ICM CM1361, which supports 6 battery cells connected in series. The two battery protection MOSFETs are from JSCJ, connected in series, and used to control the output, 60V, 2.6 mΩ. The energy management IC is also from ICM. It integrates high-precision ADC for battery voltage, current, and temperature measurement. This is a hidden switch for manufacturing. Here is the power button reinforced with glue. After introducing the battery protection PCB, let's talk about the buck boost circuit. The MCU and memory are under the display. Here is the ZIF connector. Next, let's look at every single component. This synchronous buck boost controller is from Southchip SC8815, used for the buck boost output of USB-A. The largest chip is the MCU from Eastsoft, which adopts LQFP64 package and M3 core. Its frequency can be up to 72 MHz. The external memory of the MCU is from GigaDevice and adopts WSON8 package. It supports 3.3 volts and can store firmware info. Two peripheral chips are from Infineon, which supports PD3.1 and adopts QFN24 package. Then remove the toroidal core inductors. Two larger buck boost inductors are used for two USB-C ports, and the smaller one is used for USB-A port. They were all pasted with poly paper. A total of three buck boost controllers are from Southchip, used for the voltage conversion of three USB ports. There were eight buck boost MOSFETs for synchronous buck boost conversion, same model as the MOSFET on protection PCB. Those six solid capacitors are from Yongming and are used for input and output filtering. 150 microfarad, 35 volts for each one. A synchronous buck converter is from MPS, used to power the control circuit. It supports 30 volts input and 1 amp output. A 10 microhenry inductor is next to it. The blue filter capacitor is above the inductor. Those six MOSFETs are marked with 40P68. Four buck boost MOSFETs for USB-A can form an H-bridge marked with S4480. This is a widely used protocol chip of the USB-A from Jadard. The gravity sensor is marked with 655P9H, used to detect the display rotation. The USB-C one is blue, and the connector is next to it. It can connect two PCBs. The USB-C 2 is on the other PCB, the socket is next to it. The USB-A is also blue. Well, that's all components of this Anker 140W PD3.1 power bank. It's equipped with 6 21700 battery cells and connected in series. The buck boost conversion and protection PCB are connected through multiple pins. It's also the world's first PD3.1 power bank, which can be up to 140W output and input. So you can even use it to fast charge the 16-inch MacBook Pro 2021. Moreover, it can self-charge to 70% in 30 minutes, pretty fast. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!